Hey guys, what's going on? It's Don here from Novaspirit Tech, and today we are going to be installing macOS System 7.55 on our Raspberry Pi using vMac emulator. So let's get started. So here's a little preview of what I'm doing on my macOS. Doesn't this bring back so much memories? And imagine all the games that when you were a child you wanted to play. Here's your chance. Now before we begin, I gotta say that I had a lot of fun doing this. I didn't imagine I did. It's a lot of nostalgic feelings coming back when I'm playing a lot of the old games on Mac. It was a lot of fun doing this project. I did simplify everything, so I made it so you just need to download a couple of things. When I did it, I had to download a billion things, then compile, then do it again. It was a huge headache. So I'm gonna sum everything up so you only have to download a couple of files. Alright, so to begin, we're going to head over to my website. I'll leave all the links in the description below. Download this file, which I already did download, and then head over to, you see where it's ROMs? I can't distribute the file, but I can at least show you where to get them. Once you head over to this website, you're going to download mac2.7zip. And that's going to download the ROM file so it allows it to boot up the system. Okay, after everything's all downloaded, I'm gonna create a folder in my root of my Raspberry Pi. So I'm gonna do cd make dir mac. And then I'm gonna copy the stuff that I just downloaded called mac.7z over to my folder mac. And I'm gonna cp download, what was that other thing called? 977. Something something Macintosh dot 7z to Mac. I'm going to change my directory to Mac now. I should have two files in there right now. So what I'm going to do is p7zip dash d to decompress. There you go, decompress Mac 7z, and then I'm going to decompress the next file. Now if you guys don't have 7zip, you could just do sudo apt-get install p7zip and it'll install the software for you. Now the next one I'm going to do is p7zip dash d 97, and I hit tab to autocomplete. Now that both the files are done and extracted, I'm going to move the 97 to capital M-A-C, two I's, which is Mac 2, dot capital R-O-M. That's what you need for the software to know that that's the file. Now that is done. I also included the Windows version. I compiled the Windows version with Mac 2, 8 megs of RAM, color, and all that stuff. So if you want to play this on Windows, it's fine. I have it in this file too if you want to download it. Now, first thing we need to do is create a disk. So we're going to call it, we're going to use my software called, so we're going to do sh.space.mkmacdisk.sh. So I just wrote this little script that will download the software that you need to create the HFS file system and also create it and also allow you to adjust the name and the size of it. Okay, let me minimize this so this one's easier to see. I'm going to name the disk Mac, and the size of it is, you could do anything. So I'm going to say 200 megabytes. All right, there we have it. So we should have a file called mac.disk. All right, so now that everything's all set up for us to do stuff, we're going to run mini vmac. If I could type. Oh, you know what I need to do? chmod plus, to turn it into executable, mini vmac. Now I can run it. All right, here we have it. It's gonna say that you're gonna have this little error with the disk. So the way I compiled this, this is half the size of a 1080. So when you full screen it, it looks a lot better. First thing we need to do is open our files manager. This way it's much easier to do what we need to do. Go to that folder that we created, and there's a System 7. Throw the install right in, and it's gonna boot up to install 7.0. Once this is loading, if you want to make this faster, here's a little cheat. Hold Control H, hit S for speed up, and A for all out. So I'm going to hit OK. And now it says it can't be installed on install disk one. So that disk that we made earlier called mac.disk, just drag that right in, and now you can install it. Okay, now that it asked me for the second disk, I'm gonna go back and drop this second image. Now it's gonna ask me for that, and drop the third image. Printing, drop the printing image. Fonts, drop the fonts image. And stick the install image back in. And it was successful. Now we could hit quit, restart our system. It's still gonna look for a disk, so let's go back into moving our Mac disk over. And now it boots up into 7. Now you're gonna notice it's just black and white and not really that cool. We're gonna get to that part in a sec. Move your install disk over. And in here, I have 7.55 and 7.53. So the 7.53 is what we need to upgrade first. So we're gonna install the 1 of 19, agree. And it's gonna basically upgrade the system from 7.0 to 7.53. Now here's the trick. Don't just hit install. You have to go to custom install. Because if you don't do custom install, you can't get color working. So basically select everything here, because that's what we all want. And mouse wheel doesn't work, I forgot. Everything, you just want to install everything. Make sure you didn't miss anything. Now in this system software over here, what we're gonna do is just check off this one, the top one, software for this Macintosh. Hit install. All right, so here we are, we're done with this installation, and we could just hit the little restart button, and you're gonna have to load in the Mac disk again. I'll teach you how to get rid of that or fix that in a second, but let's boot into the Mac, and you're gonna notice that now when we boot it up, it's actually gonna be able to do color. So it's rebuilding the desktop. Now we got this little cool desktop icon thing, and I'm gonna give this a second while it's doing its thing. And then we still need to do one more upgrade from 7.53 to 7.55. They made some pretty significant changes between that time, so I would definitely try to do that. Now to change everything into color, just select this little thing called display, change it to 256 color, and there we have it, color Mac. Now, once we move back into the installation disk, we're gonna close this. I don't think I need the 7.55. Oops, I clicked on the wrong one. Continue, this one was the 7.01 system. I just threw it in there just in case. But you gotta click the 7.55 update 1 of 3, and it's gonna extract the files for you. And you need to use this program called DiskCopy. So what DiskCopy does is basically allows you to open those files. And it's pretty smart actually, you could just drag and drop. And then now it creates that image. I could hit install. And it's gonna bring me to 7.55 upgrade, basically upgrade from 7.53 all the way to 7.55. Now, before I get ahead of myself, I actually have to do the rest of these files to mount the rest, I think. Let's do that. Now I hit install, it should be able to read all the disk images all in one shot. Now, hit agree. And all we have to do is just hit install. All right, time to reboot. And remember I said I was going to teach you how to fix this? Let's do that now. So basically in the command line, you just have to type in minimac vmac and your disk. And now it's always going to load that disk every time you restart. I'm going to show you a couple of things that I've been doing on this operating system to get everything functional, you could say, or more or less fun. So obviously you can see that there's a lot of new, a lot of old programs, Notepad, everything seems to work. There are configurations that you could do in settings just to change the colors. If you want to change the desktop wallpaper, I believe it was like control panel colors, I believe. Desktop patterns, there you go. If I switch to desktop patterns, I could make it look pretty cool. I like to choose this one. I don't know why, it's just the grayer of the gray. There is no internet. There's actually a plugin that you could try to get the internet. I haven't got that to work. I don't really care for it. I don't really need it. If I needed the internet, I'll just hop right out. To get it to full screen, you do H. You see how there's a help menu? And then you do F for full screen. And that's how full screen looks like. Double of 1080. So it looks a lot. It's a very easy to read. And it feels like a really cool Mac when you do this. Now that we have all our systems and everything in place, what can we do with this? Now, here's the cool part. I'm going to get out of full screen for now. And I'm going to show you. There's a bunch of websites that I found. My Abandonwares basically have games from all that time. Full games. If you wanted to look for Mac games, basically, click on Mac. And it has games that you are so used to. Oh, man. Brings back memories. And then my old Mac software. This is another website called Macintosh Repository. I'm going to leave all the links on my website so you know where to get all this stuff. If you need games or anything or Microsoft Word or Photoshop or stuff like that, just to bring back the old feelings, here it is. So, okay. It's not popping up as the first find because I should have just typed in SimCity 2000. And when you click on one of these packs, scroll down a little bit and it'll tell you what operating system it's for. So basically you have system 7X all the way to 9.22. So this will work on our system. So after you download this, you could load it into your Mac and then play the game. This is what I'm using called Mini VMac, and it allows me to compile to ARM. That's why I'm using this version. Now here, they actually have a bunch of software that you could use. So when you head over to the website and hit extras, there's something called Import FI. And this software basically allows you to drag and drop files and everything right into the emulator. So definitely download this file and I would extract it. Show in folder. I don't even know where it's saved to because I have so many stuff over here. So extract here. Let's see, Import FI. Here it spits out a little disk image, drag that over, and now you have this program called Import FI. Now, what I would do before anything is actually move it into my Mac folder, like so. That way it's installed in my system and I don't lose it because it's a very important program. So once I hit Import FI, it's gonna have this little thing right here. I'm gonna drag, I don't know, this text file over. And as soon as I drag it over, it says select destination. I'm going to save it to my desktop. Save. There we have it. The file transferred over to my Mac system. Now, that's how you load anything you want into your Mac system without having to shut it down and using a Linux command to transfer stuff over. So anytime you want to play a game or something like that, you would have to transfer it over that way. Now, a couple of applications I would definitely suggest you to get is StuffIt Explorer. That's what they use to pack all these games. So anytime you see a file that says SIT, that means just stuff it. And the second one is Toast. Later on, when you go to the newer games, they are all CD images. So Toast is another software you want to get so you could extract the CD images and mount it and install those games. If you guys enjoyed this video, please hit that like button. I know I did. I'm still playing with the Mac on my Raspberry Pi. I can't let it go. There's so many old games I just want to play and beat. I don't know. If you guys haven't done so already, hit that little subscribe button underneath. If you want to see my previous video, hit the icon to the right. If you want to see what YouTube tells you, hit the icon to the left and hit the little circle in the center to subscribe to this channel. As I say in my nerd cave, hack till it hurts.